Morning, Kathy here from Dirty Booty Soaps, and today I'm working on, say, a future project, one for a couple of shows I'm going to have before Mother's Day. And I did a hot process soap the other day. The video is online where I used rose fragrance. It was hot process. This time I'm doing cold process. I'm going to let it cure and so I can get some nice swirls. I'm doing a basic white bar, and for a little bit of swirl on the inside, I'm using magenta mica. Like I said, we're going to scent it in rose, and it's going to go with a little washcloth. I'm going to have a washcloth, a bar of soap, and a shampoo bar. So it's going to be a package deal for Mother's Day. And so, like I said, we're going to do it just a basic white and have the magenta swirled through it. And then I'm going to pour some of the white in with some of remaining magentas just to lighten it up. And so we'll have a couple different shades, hopefully, of the magenta running through. So I'm not scenting this too heavily. I don't want it like overpowering rose, so I just want a light rose scent. So there I've got my fragrance oils. I'll get my stick blender all hooked up and ready to go. I've got my big pot here. Bring in my lye water into my oils. Get my goggles. And bring it to a light trace. Two loaves today. So here I'm going to pour some off. Oops. To do my swirls. So carefully. Little too much here. Pour some of this out. So there's that. Going to use this. I'm saving some of this magenta. I have another cup because I want to do some swirls on the top. So, and then I've got my white here. Just a little bit, just to whiten it up a little bit more. So, about time to wash my smock. I'm getting stuff all over me. Okay, so now I'm going to pour my fragrance in and hand stir it. Just a little bit in here. Hopefully getting it mixed in good. And I have some flower molds sitting off to the side just because I might have just a little too much for my two loaf molds. So if I have a little too much, I'll just make a few bars. All right, so let me mix this up here. Just a really light pink we'll have going through the bar. I guess I won't lighten this up. It's pretty light already. So let me bring my loaves over here. We'll try and pour. Whoa, are we thick? Yeah, we're thickening up. You know what? A little bit of ricing. I'm going to get my blender back and try and whip this up a little bit. Because of the rose fragrance. So we'll see if we can get this in the mold. Okay. Bang it down a bit. Get some of this rose on top. It's the thing about florals is you never know what's gonna happen. You never know. So, anyway, I'm sure it will still be a pretty bar, even though it's quite thick. Okay. So, let's spoon it in here. To try a different, something different with this fragrance next time, because it is a nice fragrance, but I want to get the pretty swirls. I think what I'm going to have to do is heat up some oils and mix my fragrance in with the oil before. That's good. Before I put it in the main batch. We'll see how that works. So let me see if I can bang this down a bit. So, make a nice. At least we'll get some texture on the top. You go with what you get, right? Right. Make it a nice high textured bar. I'm just going to add the rest of this into here and do some little bars in my flower molds. Trying to work quickly before it sets up on me too much. That's the only bad thing I said about using florals is when they accelerate. Alright, so there's that for now. I've got to get these pushed into some molds here. Hopefully. One thing, at least I soak cooler, so I'll be able to push this down a little bit with my hands. Oh, talk about super, super thick. Excuse me here. Super, super. So trying to push it into the molds here. So I expect a few thumbs down on this video. Because people seem to like to do that. But anyway. You never know. Like I said, I can't look like I'm perfect all the time, right? So just realize when you're doing a floral, this is what could happen. Not that there's anything at all wrong with the soap, because there's not. It's just in the design aspect. is not exactly what I wanted. Okay, so there's not that much left. This we will plane the backs of so they're at least nice and smooth on the back when it's done. So we won't have quite the mess here. So set this off to the side. These I want to pretty a little bit. A little bit of glitter. I had done a, it was a gardenia once like this. Did the same thing to me, the same thing. And when I cut it, it turned out to be the most gorgeous bar of soap. So it just goes to show you, I mean, even though it doesn't do what you want to design-wise. Doesn't mean it's not going to turn out. So I just wanted to stick like a little rosebud in each of the slices, and I've marked my molds along the side just to kind of give me an idea of where my slices are. Hopefully, I'm seeing this right. Hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, so there's that one. Actually line this up with this one so I can kind of see again. I'm going to look at this on the top. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that one kind of came apart. I will sprinkle little rose petals on the top. Why not? I'm in the mood for spring. We had all of our snow has melted. We had a warm front move through. I know it's a little early to, at least for our area, really think spring, but I'm hoping. Now I'm just gonna sprinkle some of these rose petals across the top with the glitter. So that's it. I didn't get to do my mica swirl on the top that I wanted to because it thickened up too fast. But it's still going to be a gorgeous bar for Mother's Day. I'm sure it'll go really cute with my washcloths. So there we go. They're not the most gorgeous bars right now. But I'm sure they're going to be beautiful when we cut them tomorrow. So, and these These will sell. I have no fear. All right, so there we go. We'll be back to do the cut. I'm gonna do my cleanup now, which is the worst part of making soap. But anyway, we'll be back to do the cut. Hello, and we're back. And we're here to do the unmolding now of our rose soaps. And I took one of these out yesterday just to pop it out a little early because I wanted to wash the mold. But we're going to do the rest of these little ones. And if you'll remember, I had to like literally force these into the mold. So, but they're cute. They're little shabby chic, rough looking soaps. But they're very cute, and they smell fantastic. So these I'll probably use for myself or give to family, because they're not the most perfect little flowers. But they do smell wonderful. So they're, you see how they're a little rough. But I'm praying my bar soaps are better. So we'll have to, hopefully they come out of the mold easy. Normally I take these out before I start filming, just in case there's any problems. But I figured I'd do it today for you. It's early here. Of course, my husband's not up yet. This is when I have my morning coffee and watch the news usually. As you can see, I have my coffee right here. Gotta have my coffee in the morning. So, okay. I'll try and gently pry the sides away. And hopefully I don't ruin the little rosies on the top when I do this. Brush these off to the side here. It's a little soft yet. Just a little. I'm gonna rinse my hands off. Very pretty. I do love the color. And probably, yeah, I'm going to have to do this one, I think, on its side. Because, yeah, it's too tall to go through. So we'll just eyeball it here. Hopefully I can get between the roses. Take the first one off here. This is the end. Next. Yeah, this would go better if I turn it towards me. Duh. Some glycerin rivers, but still a very pretty soap. Slide through here. And if this would have stayed more liquid, I would have got some pretty swirls in there with the pink. But unfortunately, the floral fragrance wasn't going to let me do that. So instead, I had to hurry and get it in the mold. Anyway, still lovely. Cute. Even with the rivers. And I still have a rose. This one's got a little air pocket. Still a little rose in each slice. I have the news on in the background. I hope that's not too loud. A little wobbly on that one. It's still cute. Very cute. I see these will be paired up with a washcloth and a shampoo bar scented in rose. My last cut on this one. Oops, that one didn't go so well. To trim the end off of this one. Very cute. So we'll pop the other one out here quickly just to see how it turned out as well. I won't make you watch me cut the whole thing, but we'll see how this one looks. Feel the soap releasing. Very cute. Again, watching where my roses are. Very cute. You notice I still have glycerin rivers in this one, but still a very pretty bar. If it weren't for the rivers and the fact that it accelerated so fast on me, that was the major thing that upset me. I still like this soap. It still turned out gorgeous. And like I said, I'll show you here. For Mother's Day, we will be pairing it up with a nice washcloth. So you get the washcloth, a soap, and a shampoo bar, all in rose. And you'll notice the washcloths are also a little rose colored. The colors go very nicely together. We'll make a lovely gift for your mother, your wife, your significant other. Anyway, there we go. I won't make you watch the rest of me, the rest of the cuts, but that's what we're going to do for Mother's Day. We're going to wrap these soaps in a really pretty pink tissue paper as well. So we'll have the soap wrapped in the tissue paper on top of the washcloth, and then we'll put this on top and tie it together. And it's going to be just beautiful. Just beautiful. So there you go. Our little rose soaps for Mother's Day. The tops are really pretty with the little rose petals and the glitter. Little touch of glitter. They smell beautiful. They really do. Really nice soap. Even with the glistering rivers. So, hope you guys have a lovely day. Don't be afraid of florals just because they accelerate. You're just going to have to, I guess, be ready for it, you know? Never fails. I'll try something different if I do a floral fragrance again. I'm going to try mixing the fragrance in with a little heated oils before adding it to the main batch, and we'll see if that helps with the acceleration. But overall, I'm pleased. So there you go, our Mother's Day rose soaps. Everybody have a wonderful day. And we'll see you on the next video. Bye for now.